Wellness, and I'm here with two of my Instagram friends.
Hello.
Oh my god, yeah. You legit met your Instagram.
Is it echoey? It's a little echoey. I am about to meet two girls from Instagram, and Instagram has been awesome. Like, I can't believe how many friends I've met. So they're on the way here. We're gonna do some yoga together, and I'm super excited to meet them. It's gonna be so much fun. Stay tuned. Yeah, I'm nervous. Can you tell I'm nervous? Like, I feel very shy right now.
You guys are great.
I started my account because I severely injured my ankle ligaments, and now I'm in Lotus.
And I started my account because of my hormonal imbalances, my gut issues, my PCOS, and blah, blah, blah. So today, these two ladies are super bendy and are gonna try and teach us how to Lotus.
To grab it and hold it so that you're not pulling it towards you, but it's like a platter. Yeah, like a platter.
A platter on your foot.
Yeah, so the next move is to bring it up and towards your belly button. It doesn't have to touch, doesn't have to go near. This closes the knee joint so that you don't injure the knee. So if you feel any knee pain, you want to stop because this is a very knee sensitive pose. And basically if your knee is moving, it's easy to injure. So when you bring it up towards the belly button, then that's when you bring it across to close the knee joint. And that's one leg. So we're just gonna show here.
Okay.
Just stretch for a bit. We could do both sides.
Yeah. And do you wanna push this down?
No, okay. Just leave it up.
Okay.
So when you fold, it'll naturally go towards the ground, but you're only gonna fold as far as feels good. Okay. So the important part about folding, this is a little tip that no one tells you about. It's called the Maha Mudra. So when you grab the foot, you're actually gonna inhale, straighten the arms over the chest and lift the chin last, and then you fold on an exhale. And it actually helps you get more into the pose because it sets the tummy in, and then it gets it over the ankle so that you can fold.
Okay, question, like my thigh feels like it's gonna like die.
And then the ankle.
It feels like it's like pressing down into the bone.
Yeah, so that actually is normal.
Okay.
But definitely sometimes when I do Lotus, I get that pain. And I usually don't fold as far when I get that pain because I don't want to be uncomfortable. As soon as you're uncomfortable, what's going to happen is your muscles are going to tense up.
Right.
It's not going to be nice. And so as soon as you feel that tense up, relax. You can do this move again and just come back down. And you don't even have to stay stretched. You can just keep doing this move over and over again.
You get the same benefits.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not there yet. I think the best thing is just to rock who you are. People get inspired by someone fully being themselves and not caring what other people think. Because it's really easy to get caught up being like, oh, well, there's always gonna be a better yoga page than me or a wellness page than me. Like, why am I even doing this? How can I even inspire people?
I felt like that when I was just starting.
It's normal.
And I was like, I remember I was brought to tears sometimes because it was a yoga challenge I was doing. This is when I really just started and I couldn't do a simple half lotus, right? And everyone else in the feed did it. And I'm like, oh my god, so
it's just like I feel uncomfortable posting meat because it's so good. We are vegan. And I'm like, I eat so much meat.
Yeah.
But I have to because like I can't. But there's nothing wrong with everyone having their own diet because that's for them. It's super easy to start comparing yourself.
And it's not even to compare yourself with other people.
It's just
the sense of community.
What are your tips to not get so caught up in Instagram?
Honestly, what helped me a lot was taking more of my practice off of Instagram.
Right.
Practicing a lot for myself more. And I found the reason why I did yoga, and then that helped me understand kind of like a bigger picture that this whole Instagram thing is only one part of yoga.
I thought of it in terms of progress. So instead of comparing myself with other people, I would always do these progress photos. I don't necessarily have to post it, but just doing it, even like putting the dates and stuff, just makes me feel happy.
I love doing this, and it's also your journey, like it's your journal.
Exactly.
So you get to like go to your own post and look at me like a year ago.
Because for me, yoga is very much healing as it is. And it calms me down, and I honestly was a very impatient person.
Why were you late?